This week's Word Up is God has a plan. Sometimes it may not seem like it. Difficult things happen to everyone because the world is messed up by sin. But God knows that bad things happen and He has the power to work, even when life is tough. He will work out His good plan for all those who believe in Him. Day after day, month after month, year after year, the Israelites continued to ignore God. They believed in Him and then they went back to their sinful ways. This repeated for many years. Eventually, they became so wicked that not only their enemies attacked them, but the Israelites started attacking each other. But God did not forget them. He still loved them. God never stopped working. He was still at work to keep His promise of sending a Savior. There came a time when there wasn't much food for the Israelites. They were in great famine. An Israelite woman named Naomi and her family were so hungry, so they left the promised land of Canaan and moved to the nearby country of Moab. They were probably excited that Moab had plenty of food, but Moab was also a very evil place. The Moabites did horrible things and they served their false gods, the false idols. Do you think God loved these people? Yes, He does. God loves all people, even the Moabites. And He was about to do something great and to show His great love for the Moabites. After they moved, Naomi's sons married Moabite women. Then something terrible happened. Naomi's husband and both of her two sons died. Naomi was really sad, so she decided to return to her home in Canaan. She told her sons' wives that it would be best for them to stay in Moab with their families who would still take care of them. But Ruth, the wife of one of Naomi's sons, refused to leave Naomi. Ruth said, "Don't urge me to leave you or turn back from you. Where you go, I will go, and where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people and your God my God." Ruth chose to go to Canaan with Naomi to the promised land and serve the one true God. So Naomi and Ruth returned to Bethlehem, Naomi's home. Naomi's friends were so excited to see her again, but Naomi wasn't very excited. She was upset and angry with God because her husband and both her sons died, and she had to move back to Canaan. And now she was poor and had no way to earn money to buy the things she needed to live. Remember, during this time, way back in history, this was when women couldn't own their own land or house or property to, you know, make a living for themselves. It was always done through the man of the family, like the dad or the father. And this was during a time when the Israelites were not obeying God and were very sinful. So Naomi and Ruth just couldn't expect people to be nice to them and help them out because the Israelites were being very selfish. Naomi and Ruth were in a terrible, impossible, hopeless situation. Because they were poor, Ruth decided to do something called gleaning. Before God had brought the Israelites into the promised land, He gave them a way to show His love for poor people, widows, orphans, and strangers. God had commanded the Israelites to leave a little grain behind when they harvested and gathered the food from their fields and gardens. People who needed help could gather the food that was left behind so they would have something to eat. This was called gleaning. Ruth decided to glean in the fields so she and Naomi would have food to eat. She went to a field where men were harvesting grain and began picking up the grain they left behind. While Ruth was working, Boaz, the owner of the field, noticed her and asked his workers who she was. Boaz was very impressed when they told him who Ruth was and how she left behind everything in Moab to come to Bethlehem with Naomi. Boaz was a rich and powerful man who loved God. He was the boss in his fields, and everyone had to do what he said. He decided to use his power and his money to show kindness to Ruth. Boaz went to Ruth and told her that she should glean in his field as long as she wanted. He even told her that he would protect her from anyone who might want to hurt her as she gleaned in the fields. He even provided water and food for her. Ruth was very surprised. Because she was from Moab, she was not expecting such kindness. You see, most Israelites and Moabites at this time did not really like each other. But God was using Boaz to show kindness to Ruth, even though she was poor and not an Israelite. That night, Ruth went home and told Naomi what had happened and showed her how much food she had gathered. Naomi was very surprised and excited that God was using Boaz to show them such great kindness. Naomi was also excited because Boaz was a close relative. God had put Ruth in just the right field. They agreed that Ruth should accept Boaz's invitation to glean only in his field and receive his protection and kindness. Can you guess who else was working this whole time? It was God. God never stopped working in the lives of Naomi and Ruth. God has a plan. God knew they needed food and protection, so he used Boaz to provide these things for Naomi and Ruth. But God also knew about a greater need that they had. They needed a kinsman redeemer. A kinsman redeemer is someone who uses his close relationships to care and provide for family who can't take care of themselves. On their own, Naomi and Ruth were going to be poor and helpless for the rest of their lives. Because like I said, back then, women couldn't own their own house, land, or property, and couldn't have a job to earn money. Boaz was helping them now, but if he ever stopped helping them, they might starve and someone might hurt them. They needed someone to redeem them by making them part of his own family and then caring for them. Who do you think could be a kinsman redeemer for Naomi and Ruth? The best way for this to happen would be for someone from Naomi's family, from her Israelite family, to marry Ruth. But Ruth was from Moab and she was very poor. Most Israelite men would not want to be kind to her or even marry her. Naomi knew that Boaz would be able to redeem them if he was willing to marry Ruth. She told Ruth to go to Boaz and ask if he would redeem them by marrying her. How do you think Ruth felt about that? Ruth decided to follow Naomi's instructions and be obedient, even though she knew that most Israelite men would never want to marry her. That night, Boaz was camping in the field with his workers to guard the crops. Ruth quietly went to the place where Boaz was sleeping. At midnight, Boaz woke up and he saw Ruth. He was very surprised when Ruth said, "I am your servant, Ruth. Spread the corner of your garment over me, since you are a guardian redeemer of our family." Ruth wasn't trying to trick him into marrying her, just because she was beautiful, but she was asking him to marry her so that she and Naomi would be redeemed from their helpless situation. Boaz replied, "The Lord bless you, my daughter. This kindness is greater than which you showed earlier. You have not run after the younger men, whether rich or poor. And now, my daughter, don't be afraid. I will do for you all you ask. All the people of my town will know that you are a woman of noble character." Now, Ruth was surprised. Boaz loved her, but he had thought she would never want to marry him. He really wanted to marry her. Boaz was willing to redeem her. God had faithfully provided a redeemer for Ruth. Boaz and Ruth got married, and now Ruth and Naomi had someone who would take care of them for the rest of their lives. After Boaz and Ruth got married, they had a son named Obed. Naomi really enjoyed being a grandma, and the family lived together in Bethlehem. Obed eventually grew up and had sons, grandsons, and great-grandsons. And one of Obed's sons was named Jesse. If you remember, Jesse was the father of David, like David and Goliath, who would later become King David. And over 1,000 years later, another son would be born in Bethlehem, who would be our Savior. Who is that? It's Jesus. Jesus came from the family of Ruth, Naomi, and Boaz. And also, do you know who Boaz's mom was? It was Rahab. Remember Rahab from our previous story? God faithfully worked to complete his plan to provide a redeemer for the sins of the whole world. Jesus is the redeemer. Even when you sin and when you are in a difficult, hopeless situation, pray to God and believe that he is working. He has a plan for you and me. Even when you can't see it or you don't feel it, God is always working. You just have to be patient, be obedient, and be prayerful. I hope that you will turn to God when you have a difficult, hopeless situation. Remember that this week as you read more about the story of Ruth and Naomi in the book of Ruth.